leg.
It's only holding us down.
So let me explain this to you. So it's called the Wander Club, right? And these rings all say like the name of a country or a state. So pick the ones that you travel to. You got Rucho a matching one too. I got her blue. And I got you guys Italy and Spain.
I got you Tennessee and I got her Florida.
This one really thoughtful. I really love it.
I knew you would.
Look what we got from our mom. Facial hair removers.
So this is a normal mimosa and this is an alcoholic
mimosa.
Thank you for all of being here together. Charmaine is still in the shower.
Angela's in Disney, Miss you Angela.
Hold on, I don't want to do
Wait, I can't zoom in. Wait, this way? This way.
Alzate Films, we are the competitors to the Alzate Films. Alzate, alright?
I gotta dress some money.
We don't have any black friends in our group.
All right,
fucking racist, you.
Did you realize that?
Damn it.
John's like going to the question.
Ladies, he's single, but he's not.
Two.
But he is.
He thinks he is.
He is.
I
he is
actually.
He is too.
Be a Brad brother.
No, everyone's gonna shout out.
Wait, what?
Not him though. That's don't look at him.
Give him a test run. Oh.
Let's catch.
John, are you mad that I never got a hat from you?
No, I don't care.
I don't make any money.
I was telling Sam, if you were a good friend, you would support because like literally it's 18 bucks.
If I made merch, would you buy it?
I would buy it.
He's a better friend than me. He does the White Chocolate Academia.
Oh yeah.
Sponsor, hashtag spot. Sharp
knife. Mm.
Yeah. 10 out of 10.
That is a scissor.
Dog shit.
Sorry.
This is going to be the teaser for our podcast.
I don't know what I do with that.
All right. What's the name of it?
More alcohol.
What's like a cool like pun?
Yeah, just listen to this one.
All right, guys.
You're better at this.
I don't know if you guys know, but they're getting a head start. And we're like
stop
not doing
shit.
Can we turn around and take a look at this?
Babe, I'm busy.
Hello.
I'm pointing with the camera at my car.
Look at how much we're losing. Look at how much we're losing. We're losing.
Dude, you see what he's doing?
Dude, right? Check it out. I'm gonna sell my
car. Oh, he's almost done, y'all. He's almost.
Yeah, that's not as good.
Ew, you like raisin cookies? You probably eat ass too.
If you want, you can like microwave it.
Oh, lady in the trap, lady in the trap.
Oh my god, he went so in.
All right, babe. All right.
You gotta eat it like the booty.
Oh my god.
I'll find you the other one.
No, I will. You take this one.
What the fuck?
I'm so glad that we bought these gingerbread cookies because it turned out so perfectly.
2 minutes and 37 left.
What's wrong with you? Stop it.
Whenever I read Sam's Twitter, I go to John's Twitter and make myself happy.
Oh my god. No.
Looks like we got that one on film.
You don't have a ride home anymore. No ride home. I drew my
lunch up. Put that machete down.
Sam just raised a knife.
I'm scared.
She's getting belligerent.
I'm scared.
Davey, yes.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Davey from what?
God doesn't want to come out.
No way he understands this.
Yeah, but you know, Christmas and Christmas Eve.
No, he was actually
busy. Am I forgiven?
Am I not family?
He was actually busy.
Another guy through that.
We were going to go out early.
Do you know what you're doing with all of this?
I don't know, but I think I'll figure it out. This is what a STEM degree looks like, my friends.
But go on then.
Roy, what's all this then?
Is that dog food?
Oh my god.
This is it.
That looks like dog food.
This is really
I've never seen someone so sad in front of such a great gingerbread house.
Can I try?
Mustafa, do you think I'm pretty?
Please try.
Do you think I'm pretty?
Sam, I think you're the prettiest girl I've ever seen in my whole entire life.
I don't like
fuck
liars.
Every other girl out there.
Oh my god.
Jonathan doesn't even say that's so sad.
Yo, he lying.
That motherfucker lying.
Literally, December 31st, last day of the year, I'm on my way to work right now. And I've been meaning to like talk to the camera about, you know, 2019, a year in review. I'm not really in the mood for it, to be honest. This year was long. It saw a lot of achievements. I graduated college, I bought my own car, I started working full time. But it also saw a lot of challenges in terms of what it took to finally graduate, and also in terms of relationships in general. So 2019 is where the year was connect. I mentioned in my 2018 year in review that my goals were to connect better with people. I definitely think I did that. I got so much closer with my coworkers this year. I've been interning at the same place for forever, and I always felt a disconnect from my coworkers because they always felt so much older than me, and they're not really that much older than me. It was just a huge gap between, like, yes, working full time, and then this like tiny little intern baby. Something I never saw myself being able to do, but I'm really happy with how it happened. Connecting better with friends, I definitely feel like I did that as well. Being in school always made me so sad and stressed all the time. When I was in school and I always had like exams and deadlines to be worrying about, never felt like I was justified in having fun sometimes. So like sometimes people would message me and I would just be annoyed. I'd be like, why are you trying to make plans with me when I have all these things coming up? Because I'm an engineering student and my life is so hard and my life revolves around school. But like, no, like shut up. Shut up, bitch. So it feels good to finally just have my shoulders unclenched and be able to enjoy time with my friends and, you know, send them memes once in a while. I do that so much more often now, sending memes. And it's kind of funny to me because it's like something so tiny and such a cursory action really demonstrates to me how much I've been able to grow as a person through this past year. And just because I really did allocate all of my time and energy towards school when I was in college, and it feels good to be able to look at myself now and think, you know, I'm so much more relaxed and I have my priorities more in order. What else?
connecting better with people in general. I've been on like so many adventures this year. I went out with a lot of people that like I'm really not super close with, and to come out of it having a good time, that is something that I also never saw myself doing. I've always seen myself as someone who is more introverted and kind of just sticks to a limited group of people to hang out with. But like for me to ask on my Instagram story like, hey, does anyone want to go to a concert with me, and then for someone to respond who I'm not super close with, but you know, still going with them and still having a great time, I thought that was so cool. What else? Reconnecting with being home, that's been a big thing. Going from like living in a dorm and essentially being almost completely independent to going back to like my parents' house and things like that, it's been weird. It's been hard going out and like, you know, going out to the club and then to come back home at like 4 a.m. like, oh, it's been interesting as well. And it's made me realize that I don't know how to take care of myself, and that's why, that's another one of my goals for 2020. Sidebar, my word for 2020 is discipline, because I wanna, you know, stop allowing myself to rely on the luxuries that come with living with my parents. Because like, to be honest, like I want to move out. Another part of my word of the year is connecting with myself, really allowing myself to explore like my coping mechanisms and my anxiety, why I feel certain ways about certain things. Right now, 2019 saw a lot of challenge but also a lot of growth. My 2020 word of the year, because we out here, vision 2020 is discipline. As I mentioned before, I want to resist the urge to one, spend money, because your girl still doesn't know how to spend money, and how am I supposed to move out when I can't save up? Second, I want to resist the urge to skip the gym. Oh yes, gym. I started my fitness journey. I don't know, I'm running out of words to say. I'm literally in the parking lot at work and I'm late already. I want to carry that over to 2020 and I want to do it even bigger this time. What else? I skip meals a lot just because like I forget to eat, which is terrible, and I'm the size of a twig and I do want to gain weight and become healthier. And four, I want to learn how to resist the urge to drain my energy for other people, because I am such like a yes woman, for absolutely no reason other than to just please other people. I do too much for the wrong reasons, and I want to be able to start recognizing what is and what is not worth my energy and focus solely on developing myself for myself, not for you. Anyway, I'm late to work. Thanks for watching. It's a long video. You probably didn't even finish it. Bye. Wish I was back in Texas. The ocean's no place for a squirrel. I was in Texas, prettiest place in the world. Oh no, deep in my heart, I'll always be a Texas girl. I wanna wake up in Texas. I miss those wide open skies. Wish I barbecue become pie. Texas, all I can do is cry. Yodelay, oh, yodelay, oh, yodelay, oh, lay, lay.
kind of harmonized.
Comment, rate, subscribe, follow her.